Hey, I'm sure by now you've heard that the real estate market is on fire. If you've heard me talking at all in the last year, you've heard that or just seen it in the news, your friends, whatever. So a natural question to ask is it a good time to invest in real estate, right? Like maybe you already have a house you live in, whatever, you haven't figured that out, you've got that done. But should you invest? Should you buy a rental property? And so today I want to talk about whether it's a good time or not to buy a rental property in 2021. I'm going to talk about the pros and the cons and give you both sides sort of the argument and help you figure out what makes the most sense for you. Hey, my name is John Gluch. I'm the team leader of the Gluch Group. We run teams both in San Diego and in Phoenix, sell a couple hundred houses a year. Lots of those are rental properties, vacation rentals, long-term rentals. So know this space really well. I've also owned many rental properties myself, as have many of my team members. So I want to give you the, first of all, I want to talk about this. What's the market look like? A really quick snapshot. So let me move my big face out of the way here and show you what's going on. So this is the Cromford Market Index. It's an amazing indicator of what's going to happen to pricing, because what we really want to figure out is, okay, to make this decision, should I buy a rental property? One of the factors I'm going to talk about is appreciation. Are home prices going up? Because that's part of how you make money in a rental property, right? So let's take a look at the chart here. You could see the black line here. And I got my little handy drawing tool here. You can see this black line, you know, that I'm tracing here. That deal, what it is that's the Cromford Market Index. That's the number that is generated that tells you how hot the market is. This amazing guy named Mike Orr creates this. And as you can see, it's a very strong predictor of appreciation. When the market index goes up, then prices are soon to follow. That's this home appreciation, all these blue lines. And when it goes down, give it time and prices will go down, right? So you could see 2005, it did an amazing job of predicting the boom. And then of course the bust, not so fun down here. And since then, it's done an incredible job, very predictably, telling us what's gonna happen to prices. Now, pay attention to the right side of the line here. Oh, this is, you know, Uncle COVID shows up, no fun, it's March, and then bam, holy crap. Like, we are at all-time record highs for the Cromford Index. As you can see, much higher than 2005. What's gonna happen to appreciation? Well, take a guess. It's gonna go up. It's already insane. We're seeing this on the streets with my team, multiple offers, over asking price. It's madness, okay? Absolute craziness. So I'm gonna talk about this little bubble thing here, because that's of course the thing you're afraid of when you see this big spike. What's gonna happen, right? I've talked a lot about bubbles bursting. Check out our blog page for that. You'll see tons of information, like full-blown posts about why I don't think there's a bubble. I would check those out. But suffice to say, appreciation will be very good this year. So that's one of the factors. So I wanted to take a quick look at that. And let me tell you also, kind of show you, this is nationwide. So here we've got total home inventory in all of the U.S. And gosh, just falling off a cliff. Like, you know, this time in, what was that, 2015? Like, over a million properties for sale, now 344,000. That's craziness. That's absolute craziness. Again, in other videos, I've talked about why that's happening. Suffice to say, that really matters. And then let me talk real quick about the rental market, because this matters too. The rental market is just as hot as the sale market, right? So you can see dollars per square foot here has gone up, 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 up. It's very expensive to rent properties right now, just like it is to buy properties. So all of that you need to know for the conversation we're gonna have right now, which is, should you buy a rental property? So here's what I think. There's a couple upsides. One is cash flow, right? You want to earn more every month, collect more money than you spend, right? Now, I just showed you rents are up a lot. That's awesome, right? But so are prices. So you're gonna pay more for the house, your mortgage will be higher. Now, interest rates are really good, so that helps. But your cash flow on a long-term rental isn't gonna be amazing. Put 20% down and you'll probably break even. You know, you can put more down, right? If you put all, if you just buy cash, of course you're going to have positive cash flow because you don't have a mortgage to pay. The more money you put down, the lower your mortgage payment is and the better your cash flow is. But while cash flow is good and it is a nice upside in rental real estate, it's not amazing right now. Now, rent rates will probably keep going up. And as a result of that, eventually your cash flow will get better and better every year. It'll keep marching up in theory, right? So, but right now to make cash flow, you know, it's a nice bonus, but it's not huge. I always recommend make sure you put enough down to get some kind of cash flow. You don't want to be negative. A lot of people got into trouble doing that in the early 2000s. Don't do that. Make sure you got some positive cash flow, but you know, you're not going to make hundreds and hundreds of dollars a month on your rental property. Second is appreciation. Now that's the game we're winning right now, right? The homes are appreciating, I think, 18% this year in Phoenix and San Diego, maybe more. So, I mean, think about the numbers on that. Let's say you buy a $300,000 house. It appreciates 18%. That's like $60,000, $50,000 worth of appreciation. You put 20% down to buy the house, which is 60 grand. It appreciates 50 in a year. That's like almost 100% return on your money. Appreciation is crazy. The numbers get better the bigger you go. So a San Diego price, closer to 500 for a rental probably. The math is all the same. It's just crazy. I mean, the appreciation you're getting, the value you're benefiting from in terms of appreciation right now is off the charts. Okay, item number three is tax benefits. Talk with your CPA about this, but depending on your tax situation, how much money you make, that kind of thing, that's another benefit of rental real estate. That's part of the upside of owning a rental is you can write off depreciation and expenses and all kind of other stuff. So a couple upsides there, really valuable ones that are in the four column of like why you should buy a rental property. All right, now the downside. It's going to take some work. You know, there's a reason I don't have 50 rental properties, and it's because I got a company to run and a family to take care of. And I can't manage all that. I've done lots of that in the past. My focus is way more. My time and energy is on my team right now. So I'm not building a huge rental portfolio. I'm invested in more passive stuff. If you don't have a job like mine, where every hour extra you put into your job really matters and moves the needle financially, if you've got a set income, you know, then man, like, that's not a big deal. Like if you put a little time into your side hustle, into your rental game, no problem. But it's something to consider, you know, especially on the front end when you buy the property. Now you got to, you know, probably create an LLC and get insurance and get it rented and, you know, I'll set up all the bill pay. It takes time. You know, once you're up and running with a good manager, you know, 2-4 hours a week is probably, or a month is what it takes. A lot more than that if you do a short-term rental. And I did a post on our blog about short-term versus long-term rental. Going to take you more time on a short-term rental, but because you're turning over like an Airbnb, like a hotel. So there's quite a bit of turnaround there. So it does take some time. Just something to consider. Make sure that you're aware of in the process. All right. So next downside is the home cost, the maintenance of the home, right? Things go wrong. Stuff breaks. You got problems. Things flood, whatever. Like that's just part of owning a rental property that you need to be prepared for. And a good home warranty can compensate for this. So that's not a bad idea. If you've got a limited amount of cash to, for if something goes really wrong, you might get a good home warranty to help cover some of those costs. But you do need to plan on some upkeep, some different, you know, various maintenance costs and those kind of things. And those eat into your profit. And again, they take some time and energy. So something to be aware of. We recommend 5% of your gross revenue. So if you're bringing in $1,000, you know, whatever it is, 5% of that you would put towards a fund for when stuff goes wrong. So one thing to consider as well. Risk of a market correction. Again, I don't think that's going to happen. I think what's going to happen is the steam is going to run out of the market and it's going to start to flatten out a little bit. We'll get back to 3 or 5 or something percent that's more reasonable. But I don't think that's happening anytime soon. And I certainly don't think there's a bubble. Again, check out more of our blog posts for information on that. And then next, and this is a big one, you need 20% down to buy a rental property. So the other way to do this would be if you're buying another personal home that you could put maybe 5 or 10% down on and then keep the current home you already have as a rental property. That's a way to get into property cheaper. But generally speaking, you need 20% down to buy a rental property. And that's not a small amount of money. You know, in Phoenix, you're looking at about $300,000 for a decent rental property. In San Diego, it's closer to $450,000, $500,000. So, you know, that's something to consider. You've got to figure out a way to track down that cash. And that can be challenging, you know. So, you know, here's kind of what I think, big picture. I think buying a rental property is a fantastic idea right now. Like this is the best, hottest real estate market we will probably ever see. So ride the train, you know, get some of that appreciation. If you've got the money to put down, don't kill yourself. Don't spend every penny you have doing this. Make sure you've got some margin. But I think it's a great idea. If you're concerned about cash flow and you've got time and energy, I would do an Airbnb. And on those, the higher, the better in terms of price. The Airbnb I had was like $1 million property and it did amazingly well. I wish I still had it. So that market, you don't have to buy $1 million Airbnb. You can buy something cheaper that works, but that market is crushing it. You get much better cash flow and you still get all that appreciation. So if you're worried about cash flow, that's a way to go if you've got some time on your hands. If not, stick with long-term rental. And I think it's a great time to do this. I'm buying a property right now and you know, we just bought one 2 months ago. So I'm, you know, doing, practicing what I preach, right? So I do think this is a good time to do that. So those are my thoughts. We'd love to help you. Our teams in San Diego and Phoenix are very experienced at helping people find rental properties. So reach out, let me know how we can help get you started on your first rental property, or maybe it's your 10th. Either way, we'd love to help you out.